All right, we are going to run through a full service on a Honda Big Red 700. This is a 2010 model, but a lot of them are the same. The first thing we're going to do is the engine oil. Now we're going to take and drain this engine oil right underneath, kind of to the right of this prop shaft is your drain plug. That's a 17 millimeter drain plug. That bolt is 2.5-3 inches long with an O-ring in the middle of it. It's right there. And pull that drain plug out, and 3 quarts of oil should drain out of there. We're gonna go over to the other side. So this will be the passenger side of this UTV. And we're gonna pull that passenger seat. We're gonna pull the park brake plate there. And we're gonna go over here and down on the side of that crankcase is the engine oil filter. Now that takes a 12 millimeter wrench, and it's just a bolt that runs all the way through that oil filter, and you've got to pull that, and then that cap will slide off of there. Be really careful that you don't damage that by using a screwdriver to pull that oil filter cap. You're gonna pull that oil filter, replace it with a new one. Those oil filters will go either way. You don't have to put them in there. They're not directional. So the only way that it'll fit in there, there's a spring in there that you wanna have between the oil filter cover, then the spring, and then the oil filter. Slide that in, turn it back on there, torque it down. Then we're gonna go over here. This is the spark plug right underneath the park brake. Right beside would be your right hip if you're in the driver's seat. That's your spark plug. NGK spark plug number on that is BKR5E11. That's the NGK number. So replace that spark plug when you're doing a full service. Now we've got your air filter back here, and Honda comes with a cleanable, reusable air filter, and it is a foam filter. You pull these two holders here off the side, and then unsnap these 4 clips here. Pull that air filter cover and pull that off of there with a Phillips screwdriver, taking the clamp off, and then you can spray that down with oil filter oil. And make sure you use oil filter oil, not just any kind of regular oil. Now we're gonna go back over to the driver's side of this UTV, and I'm gonna show you where to fill the engine oil right here. And this takes 3.1 quarts of oil if you've drained the drain plug as well as the oil filter. 2.9 liters or 3.1 quarts. And this follows this, you fill it here, follows this tube down, goes to the bottom side of that crankcase. So you have to fill it very slowly. Then down just past the fill mark or the filler cap there is the dipstick. And that's what you use to run your engine for a minute or two, shut it off, let it sit for 30 seconds or a minute, and then check your oil filter or your oil level there. Next, we're gonna go to the rear differential, and we've got a 10 millimeter plug coming from the bottom of this differential here. You can see it, but you come from the bottom to loosen it. And from the underneath of the UTV, it is this square hole that you will find this 10 millimeter bolt in. You drain that differential oil there. And go up here after we've drained that oil. And this is your fill cap here. It's your fill cap and then your check bolt. So when you fill this up, fill it very slowly using an 80 weight hypoid oil. And as soon as you have oil coming out the top cap here, you put the cap on there and you are full. That's where you need to be at. This is about the middle of the differential. And so it's halfway up. Those gears will, bottom side of those gears will soak in that oil when the bevel gears turn. It'll lubricate that entire differential. Put that cap back on there and you're all set. We're gonna go to the front. It's very similar to the rear. We've got a 10 millimeter drain plug underneath the bottom here. Pull that 10 millimeter and that is a drain plug for the front differential. Come up here and on, it'd be the left-hand side of the UTV, right level with the drive shaft, the axle shaft coming out of there, is the fill plug for the front differential. Same thing on this one, fill it up till it starts coming out, and then you are full. Put that fill plug back in, and you're all set. Same thing, use an 80 weight hypoid gear oil on that as well. Here is your master cylinder fill. Use DOT3 or DOT4 fluid, brake fluid, and there's a minimum and maximum mark there that you stay between. Coolant up here, use a 50-50 mixture, and at the top there you see the radiator cap. Go ahead and fill that all the way to the top and replace that cap. Do not do that when that motor is hot. And that is the full service on a Honda Big Red 700.